In recent years, many businesses have faced the harsh reality of being hacked. To make an already bad situation even worse, the stolen data often lands on the dark web, ready for sale to the highest bidder. But what exactly is the dark web? Let's break it down. Welcome to our series on cyber threat management. Here, we break down complex concepts and discuss best practices so your organization can be better protected. Today, we're diving into the dark web, how it works, what lurks there, and why it matters for your business. So, what is the dark web? Let's start from the tip of the iceberg and gradually go deeper and deeper. The so-called surface web is the web we explore every day using browsers like Safari or Google Chrome. Search engines index the surface web and are public. Underneath that lies the deep web, which is hidden from search engines. Anything that is not public, like confidential corporate web pages and password-protected websites, is considered to be a part of the deep web. Apart from this traditional classification, there are messaging platforms like Telegram and Signal. Also, L2P and Jabber are in use. They might not be the part of the dark web, but they have become a tool for cybercriminals to share stolen data, discuss attack strategies, and trade illegal goods. Criminals no longer rely on the dark web forums alone. Let's talk about the mechanics of anonymity. The dark web is built on it. Threat actors use three key tools to hide their identities: virtual machines, virtual private networks, and the Tor browser, short for the Onion Router. Developed in the 90s to protect US intelligence communications, Tor encrypts your internet traffic through multiple volunteer-operated servers. Those servers are called nodes. Each node knows only the next step, making tracing the user's original location nearly impossible. This system makes it almost impossible for governments, hackers, or law enforcement to track users or their activities online. Also, websites on the dark web use .onion domains, which are not accessible through normal browsers. This further protects anonymity. Together, layered encryption and randomized routing create a system designed for privacy and secrecy. And what about the dark web's ecosystem? Let's unpack it. You should note that the dark web is not a single entity. It's a complex structure made up of different players, platforms, and rules. This ecosystem consists of both sellers and buyers. Anonymity, trust, and reputation drive the dark web. Amid scams and fraud, vendors sell everything from ransomware tools to stolen data, relying on ratings from their buyers to maintain credibility. The dark web is usually powered by cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin and Monero, making any transactions untraceable. For cybersecurity teams, the dark web proves that a supply chain exists for designing attacks against corporate networks, where criminals will buy different services and technical goods from other actors. Understanding this ecosystem can help cybersecurity teams stay ahead of the game and defend businesses against evolving threats. The key takeaway should be that information and tools on the dark web can directly identify your organization's security vulnerabilities. We can dive deeper into the hotspots for illegal activity. The first one is marketplaces. They are platforms for buying and selling illegally obtained assets, products, and services. These sites function similarly to e-commerce platforms but prioritize anonymity. Dark web forums serve as discussion boards or communication platforms for discussing illegal activities, facilitating knowledge sharing, and building community. They are crucial for information exchange, allowing criminals to stay ahead of law enforcement and improve their techniques. Extortion sites managed by ransomware groups are operated by individual cybercrime collectives. Such sites are places where ransom demands happen. Illicit chat rooms are the hidden real-time communication hubs where cybercriminals plot, plan, and execute operations. Now, let's discuss who operates behind the scenes of the dark web. It's a mix of different groups, all with their own reasons for being there. Let's name a few. Cybercriminals. These are individuals or groups that are primarily focused on theft, fraud, and extortion. They exploit vulnerabilities to steal data, often targeting businesses. For instance, there's the ransomware as a service or RAS model. Groups like LogBit, Scattered Spider, and BlackBasta offer ransomware tools for sale on the dark web forums, allowing less skilled criminals to launch attacks on businesses. These groups have been responsible for high-profile attacks, including the MGM International and Boeing incidents. Another type of people who operate on the dark web are hacktivists. Their motivation is political or social causes rather than profit. They may leak information or disrupt services to raise awareness for their issues. For example, the group Anonymous has used the dark web to organize and launch attacks against corporations and governments in response to perceived injustices. One of them was the 2010 attack on PayPal after the company stopped processing donations to WikiLeaks. Cybersecurity specialists, researchers, and journalists operate on dark web too. They prove that not all players in this ecosystem are malicious. Some researchers monitor the dark web to study threats. They aim to understand trends and inform businesses about potential vulnerabilities. So, what's sold on the dark web? Actually, a lot. However, data is the most common commodity. Criminals sell databases. Also, they offer illegally obtained assets such as documents, files, and credit cards. Extorted company data obtained by ransomware groups is also for sale, as well as sensitive data stolen from users. Criminals also sell their services. For instance, you can hire hackers to attack insecure infrastructures. Just like in the real world, prices change with the market. Hackers can cash in on everything, from stolen credit cards to Netflix accounts. Believe it or not, your Netflix password could lead to phishing attacks or even access to more sensitive accounts. You might not even know you've been hacked, and your company's info could already be on sale. How can your organization fight back against the dark web threats? No company wants its sensitive data to be sold on the dark web. There is an array of tools that can scan the dark web for emerging threats. A good monitoring system gives you a complete picture without diving deep into the dark web forums. Who wants to risk a deep dive into the dark web anyway? All in all, searching the dark web is not just about finding data for sale. It's a gateway for security teams that want to tackle emerging threats, malware trends, and even industry-specific hacking tools. With NordStellar, your company gets full visibility into what hackers know about your company. So, don't lose your business on the dark web. Get NordStellar and stay safer online.